Namaste. Today, I'll be talking about yoga and breath. And I'll also be giving you a few practices to enhance the functioning of your respiratory system. Before that, we'll begin with the pranayama mantra. In this mantra, we are acknowledging whatever is there in this three world is under the control of prana. And hey prana, like a mother protects child, you also protect us and give us that intelligence and understanding to interact with this world. Just try and feel the good vibrations of this shloka. Pranasyedham vase sarvam tridevya pratisitham Mateva putran rakshasva shishcha prajnascha videhinaiti. Om shanti shanti shanti. Breath has been given the utmost importance in yoga. When we say prana in yogic system, it's not only the physical inhalation, exhalation, but also the subtle pranic energy running all across our system. So yoga is a system to enhance the functioning of your pranic system. It becomes very important to understand and to strengthen your respiratory system, especially in this difficult time where everybody is covering their nose and mouth and moving about, which is essential. We can't avoid it, but we have to do it. But in that process, there is certain amount of waste left in our body. So it becomes very important to expel it out. Our body takes in energy mainly from through four forms. There is solid food we eat, there is liquids we drink, and the breath we are inhaling, exhaling, and then through our thought process. So any metabolic activity in our body generates lots of waste, and it becomes important to expel that waste time to time. Yoga is one such beautiful system which first cleanses your own whole system so that there is a space for your fresh energy to get into your whole body. So it is a periodic cleansing, and I call my class also repair and maintenance class, because this body is a beautiful machine. You have to keep the maintenance up. Otherwise, if you're not letting out what waste and you're just taking in, obviously whatever you're taking in won't be that healthy. Be it in solid form, liquid form, or air. So you have to expel that waste. And the yogic system is an excellent waste management science. Whenever there is an inhalation, exhalation happening, there is a three-dimensional change happening in our thoracic cavity. So our thoracic expands side, back and forth, and up and down. So when it happens, there is a shape, three-dimensional shape change for the lungs also. It is important to have a healthy thoracic and abdominal muscle to have a very strong and healthy and optimum breathing, because these are the muscles which facilitate the change in the volume of thoracic area. And as per science, physics, whenever there is an increase in volume change, the air gets into that system very effectively. So it is important for us to maintain this thoracic and abdominal area, because these are all the facilitating muscles for the shape change which occurs when we breathe in and breathe out. For example, when I'm inhaling, by inhalation, I'm first expanding the volume of my thoracic cavity. So because my lung is situated in thoracic cavity, automatically there is a lot of space for it to breathe. And the diaphragm and the abdominal muscles will allow that lung to expand downward. Our pectorals and our intercostal muscles will help it expand sideways, and our back is helping us expand towards the back. So this three-dimensional change in your lung capacity is very important, and that is why we do a lot of asanas to strengthen our muscles which facilitate the breathing. So today I'll be showing you a few practices to enhance the capacity of these facilitating muscles so that you stay strong. Once you have a strong muscular structure to hold up that rib cage, automatically your breathing becomes very efficient. Okay, so we'll just stand up. These are all general practices to enhance the strength of the muscles. So if you're comfortable, keep your feet, toes and heels together, or you can even keep your little distance between your feet. As a stable building should have a stable stable surface, that's why the Tadasana position becomes very important. Okay, so to establish that good posture, we'll bring our awareness towards the feet, distribute the weight equally on both the feet. Now visualize your knee is moving upward, your thigh is moving upward, your tailbone in and down it's moving, your sternum is nicely moving forward, shoulder is relaxed, and close your eyes. Try and feel that 3D awareness of your body. Okay, now slowly inhale, bring both the hands up, interlock your elbows. Good. If any discomfort in this, you can always take your hands up there. So here, when you're here, nicely lengthen out from your belly. Lift that ribcage up, consciously relax your shoulder socket. We'll breathe here for a few seconds. Deep inhalation, exhalation. Your thoracic region is nicely suspended upward, nicely lengthening upward, giving that lengthen upward extension. Breathe here. Now slowly, as you exhale, take your body towards the side. Maintain the length of your spine. Don't hunch your body. Don't aim to bend too much. You need to maintain the length of the spine and just move to the side. And don't push your hip also. Just feel that your serratorial anterior muscles nicely stretching out. Breathe. And slowly come back to the center. Now with next exhalation, maintaining that beautiful length, relaxed shoulders, you go to the opposite side. Again, breathe here. Any discomfort here, you can always relax one hand down and keep the other hand straight up. Breathe. And maintaining a good length, come up to the center. Slowly bring your hands down and relax in Shithilakalasana. So this is the variation for Ardha Kati Chakrasana and simple Tadasana. So one more variation to Tadasana we will do. This time, keep little hip level distance between your feet. Interlock your fingers. So we are pushing it up towards the ceiling when we go up. So inhale, come up on the toes. Lengthen out upward, keep the shoulders relaxed, breathe here. Agar aapko hold nahi ho pa raha hai, you can always keep your knee down but maintain the length of your spine. Now try and feel, send the breath all the way till your belly. Once your belly expands down and out, there is space for your diaphragm to expand, and then there is space for your lungs to breathe to the full capacity. Breathe. Now slowly come here down. Again from this angle, we are going to the side. Breathe. We'll hold here for 5 good deep inhalation, exhalation. Make sure you're not aiming to fall, go too much down. We are aiming to keep that spine up, ribcage lifted, and to the side. That's it. Breathe. Again, we'll come back to the center and to the opposite side. Feel a good length. Automatically, you'll be able to breathe better because your ribcage is lifted. There is no pressure on the lungs. There is more space for it. Enjoy that sensation and slowly come back to the center and bring your hands down. Okay, if your shoulder is hurting, you can just roll it once out and in. Now next practice to enhance the strength of your pectoral and your intercostal muscle, especially your intercostal muscle, which helps you lift the rib cage. We'll do this practice using the wall. We'll stand as near to the wall as possible and keep your hand shoulder level. Don't keep it very near, keep it shoulder level and little extra wide. So here we are keeping the hands there and keep your body straight, keep looking straight and keep pushing that wall. Nice, good push. Breathe here. 5, 4, 3, 2. Keep pushing, keep pushing. Your whole body is resisting its own weight. And 1. Slowly release, release, relax. Okay, for the next practice, we'll take a little bit wide and little bit up, okay? So little bit shoulder level, say wide and up. And yaha again, one leg aage rahega, or yaha, you push, breathe. You resist your own strength. Keep pushing the wall away from your body. Push, 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 breathe. Don't sink your shoulders, keep it out. Protract your shoulders. 5, 4. And give me a good, as if you're trying to widen the length of the room. 3, 2, and 1. Release, release. Shake your hands up. See, this practice, when you're pushing, you have to inhale deeply, exhale completely. So first you take that shoulder level and little bit wide and then push the second one little bit wide and up, and then you're pushing and breathing. When you're pushing, literally you put all your body weight, but don't hunch your shoulders. And always shoulder moving away from your ears and maintaining that pushing position. Okay. Now, then another practice we'll be doing, again, this is to enhance the lung capacity, is is your pinky fingers. Okay, what we will do again, see this level. So we are keeping our hands this way near to the wall and coming near to the wall. Agar aapko comfortable hai to touch your head. Yahan kya karenge, inhale karte hue, hands up, nicely lengthen out, breathe and exhale, release. Inhale up, yahan full length lene ke baad hold karenge, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and release. When you release, bring it down slightly a bit. One more time. Inhale, slightly widen out, lengthen out from the base of your spine. Relax your head, touch it to the wall, breathe here again. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, this is a very good practice to strengthen all the facilitating muscles. Okay, next one we are doing a little variation to Utkutasana. Utkutasana, even though we are, it is mostly our quadriceps and hamstrings are involved, but because these are the major muscles which suck in the oxygen, so we are giving that habit for our circulatory system to jump start, okay, so that it get used to that inhaling. Inhaling, exhaling with a good amount. So, because whenever there is an extra need for your body, it starts breathing deeply on its own. Okay, so for that, we'll keep hip level distance between your feet, toes ekdam samne ke taraf. Okay, yahan inhale karte hue dono haath ko upar layenge, pura fingers ko kholenge, achcha sa take a good length from the sides, lift that rib cage. Relax that shoulder socket. With next exhalation, you're slightly sitting down as if up chair pe baitho. Make sure you're not going too much to the front. You keep the tailbone in and go down. If you want back pe strain aa raha to halka sa aage jhukenge. Yahan breathe karte rahenge. 5, 4. Agar haath mein dard aa raha to you can keep it in also. 3, 2, and 1. Slowly come up and relax. So whenever you are in the posture, it's important you keep breathing. You never hold breath in the when you are doing any asana practice. Okay? ये वाला और एक बार कर लेंगे. अगर आपको चाहिए तो हाथ यहाँ भी रख सकते हैं, यहाँ भी रख सकते हैं, हाँ यहाँ. Make sure your knee is not going too much to the front. Imagine there is a chair behind you and you are trying to sit on that chair. But, okay? So, with inhalation, hands up and exhale, go sit down. Breathe here. If you feel you can go a little bit down, you can always go down. Breathe. You can lean slightly forward, but make sure you're not sticking your tailbone out, it's inside. 3, 2, and 1. Slowly come up and relax. ये हो गया उत्कुटासन. ये भी आप practice आपके हिसाब से 8 बार कर सकते हैं. Inhale करते, exhale करते नीचे जाएंगे, वहां breathing के साथ आपके हिसाब से count hold कर सकते हैं. अगर आप 10 count hold कर सकते हैं, बहुत ही अच्छा practice है, because it jump starts your circulatory and respiratory system. Okay. अभी वन मोर ब्यूटीफुल प्रैक्टिस स्टैंडिंग वाला इज अर्ध चक्रासन. सो इसके लिए हल्का सा डिस्टेंस, हिप लेवल डिस्टेंस रखेंगे. अगर आपको बैलेंस ज्यादा चाहिए तो थोड़ा ज्यादा भी बढ़ा सकते हैं. ओके, टो फेसिंग फॉरवर्ड, यहां यू ब्रिंग योर हैंड्स बिहाइंड, इंटरलॉक योर फिंगर्स. जिसको पाम साथ में हो रहे हो, पाम साथ में रखेंगे. ओके, अगर ये आपको इंटरलॉक नहीं हो रहा है तो आप हाथ ऐसा भी रख सकते हैं, ठीक है. सो यहाँ नाउ इमेजिन दैट एनर्जी मूविंग अपवर्ड, लिफ्ट lifting your whole rib cage and then you're taking your sternum up towards the ceiling. So inhale, open out the chest, lift. Once you feel you've reached your capacity, relax. Breathe. Agar zyada strain or a back pain, you can keep your knee halka sa bend, but try and keep pushing that sternum up towards the ceiling. And breathe here. Agar jisko heart nahi pahunch raha hai, wo log ye wala pen haath rakh ke rukenge. Yaha. 3, 2, 1. Okay. So, ye Ardha Chakrasana practice is also very excellent practice to open up your thoracic volume. Remember, as I said, it's very important you have a very good posture. The more you go like this, see, the more your shoulder is drooping, your chest is in, the compression for your heart and for your lungs, there is no space. When there is no space, jitna bhi breathe kare, there is no space to expand. So always, you open up, relax, feel that shoulder moving away and back and breathe. Once there is an expansion in your thoracic volume, automatically your breathing will improve. Okay, ye ho gaya standing practices. So standing practices mein humne kiya Tadasan, Ardhakati Chakrasan, wall variation 1, jahan humne push kiya wall ko, wall variation 2, jahan apne extend kiya haath ko, or then we did fourth one, Utkutasana, ye wala position, and then we did Ardha Chakrasana, ye wala. ये सब प्रैक्टिसेस आप आपके हिसाब से गुड ब्रीदिंग के साथ आपको करना है, ये अवेयरनेस के साथ करना है कि ये करने से आपका जो थोरैसिक स्ट्रक्चर है विल हेल्प यू एनहांस दैट पोजीशन पोस्चर. अभी हम जमीन पे जाएंगे. सी, फॉर एनी बॉडी टू वर्क ऑफ optimally, it needs to be strong also and supple also. So if you have a strong and supple body, your functioning of all the system will be at their maximum level. Okay, so abhi tak humne thoracic volume expand karne ke practices kiye. Abhi we'll see how to strengthen our core and our oblique muscles. These are the major muscles which facilitate the breathing. When our abdomen goes down and out, obviously there is space for your lung to expand. And for exhalation, these are the major oblique muscles, are the major muscles which facilitate that exhalation properly. To enhance that, we'll do simple practice, few sitting practices. First, we'll begin with Dandasana. Dandasana mein, aap make sure your hand is under your palm is under the shoulders. Okay? And aapka nazar yaha rehna chahiye. So, that triangle angle. Yaha hone ke baad, aap dheere se aap leg ko dono extend karoge aur yaha breathing karte rahe. Okay, make sure you're not pushing your spine up, tailbone out, or too much down. No, you control from your core, lift and hold. Your tailbone is in, your shoulder is slightly protracted, and breathe. Okay, yes, Dandasana practice is again, it's a very manifold benefit it has to strengthen your upper body and of course your core. ये वाला प्रैक्टिस भी आप आपके हिसाब से 8-10 बार कर सकते हैं, जितना काउंट आपको होल्ड करना है उतना करके. अनदर ब्यूटीफुल प्रैक्टिस इन योगा फॉर स्ट्रेंथनिंग योर कोर इज नौकासन. सो वी कम ऑन टू द मैट. फर्स्ट लाई डाउन फुल्ली प्रोन पोजिशन में. Take your hands over. Give that full body supine stretch. Okay. अभी दोनों हाथ को नीचे लाएंगे. यहां एक्सेल करते हुए यू कम अप, लुक टुवर्ड्स योर टोस, इनहेल एंड बैक. एक्सेल, कम अप, लुक टुवर्ड्स योर टो. मेक श्योर योर शोल्डर इज नॉट पिंचिंग, रिलैक्स शोल्डर्स एंड इनहेल बैक. एक्सेल अप. यहां जिसको होल्ड करने को हो रहा है वो लोग होल्ड करेंगे. जब भी होल्ड कर रहे हो यू शुड ब्रीद. ओके, अगर जिसको हल्का सा ऊपर आने को हो रहा है वो लोग ऊपर आएंगे. इफ यू कैन टेक इट अप लिटिल बिट मोर यू कैन टेक इट अप, बट मेक श्योर यू आर नॉट पिंचिंग योर शोल्डर. योर शोल्डर इज आउट एंड यू कैन कीप योर नी स्लाइटली बेंड आल्सो. ओके, जिसको सीधा हो रहा है वो लोग सीधा करेंगे, आइदर होल्ड करेंगे या नीचे आएंगे. ये प्रैक्टिस हम एक 10-12 बार कंटिन्यूस कर सकते. अभी अनदर प्रैक्टिस टू स्ट्रेंथन आउट योर ऑब्लिक मसल्स, विच इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मसल इन योर रेस्पिरेटरी फंक्शनिंग. सो फॉर दिस वी डू लिटिल बिट वेरिएशन. सो यहां दोनों टांगे ऊपर रहेगा. एक्सेल करते हुए राइट लेग इन, लेफ्ट नी एल्बो इन. इनहेल करते हुए राइट लेग अप, left out. Yeah, almost like a boat position we are coming. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. अगर जिसको neck पे दर्द है या back पे pain है वो लोग ये वाला variation कर सकते हैं. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. ये वाला वेरिएशन आप 20-20 का 5 राउंड्स भी करेंगे तो बहुत ही अच्छा रहेगा. ओके, अनदर ब्यूटिफुल प्रैक्टिस फॉर एनहांसिंग द वॉल्यूम ऑफ योर थोरैसिक इज मत्स्यासन. देयर इज अ वेरिएशन फुल मत्स्यासन जो पद्मासन से किया जाता है, बट आज मैं अर्ध पद्मासन आपको बताऊंगी. सो उसके लिए आप बैठ जाएंगे, दोनों अच्छा सा सीट बोन पे बैठेंगे. हाँ, ये नहीं रहना चाहिए. अच्छा सा हाथ को यूज करेंगे, सीधा बैठेंगे, टोस दोनों साथ में, हील साथ में, टो हल्का सा पॉइंटेड आउट. अभी हाथ अंदर की तरफ, ये ऐसा नहीं, ऐसा. धीरे से एक एक करके एल्बो को नीचे रखेंगे. नीचे रखते हुए स्टर्नम को सीलिंग की तरफ पुश करेंगे और हेड को पूरी तरह रिलैक्स करेंगे. यहां आंखें बंद करते हुए यू कैन ब्रीथ एज मच एज यू कैन. ओके, यू होल्ड एज लॉन्ग एज यू फील नाइस अबाउट इट. This is a very excellent therapy practice even for people with back problem and for the sinus. There's a lot of benefit from this posture. Okay, this matsyasana aap aapke hisab se hold karte hue breathe karenge. Abhi one more posture, bhujangasana. Because aaj hum log bhujangasana mein bhi kafi sara variation hai. आज हम लोग सिंपल एक्टिव भुजंगासन करेंगे. सो दोनों साथ में, हील साथ में. अगर आपका पाव ऐसा हो रहा है देन डिस्टेंस रखेंगे दोनों फीट के बीच में. नहीं है तो दोनों टोस और हील साथ में रहेगा या पूरा लोअर बॉडी एक्टिव रहेगा. दोनों हाथ चेस्ट के पास, एल्बो अंदर की तरफ, शोल्डर्स रिलैक्स, फोरहेड ऑन द ग्राउंड. यहां इनहेल करते हुए ऊपर आएंगे, एक्सेल करते हुए नीचे. इनहेल करते हुए ऊपर, एक्सेल करते हुए नीचे. यहां एल्बो टो के तरफ जाते रहना चाहिए. ओके, डोंट ओपन योर एल्बो आउट. और जब भी ऊपर आते हो एकदम ये नहीं करना है,
हाँ ये वाला जरूर नहीं करना, बस आज के लिए सिंपल ब्रीदिंग का प्रैक्टिस है, इनहेल अप एक्सहेल डाउन, बस इनहेल अप एक्सहेल डाउन। इसके बाद आप थोड़ी देर मकर आसन में रिलैक्स करेंगे, ऑब्जर्व करेंगे। ओके, दोनों फीट साथ में और ऊपर आके वज्रासन में बैठेंगे। अगर आपको वज्रासन में बैठने नहीं हो रहा है तो आप सिंपल क्रॉस लेग होके भी बैठ सकते हैं, या आपके पास एक्स्ट्रा मैट है तो उसको अच्छा सा रोल करके उसको रख के उसके ऊपर भी आप बैठ सकते हैं वज्रासन। ओके, नहीं है तो जस्ट सिट हियर वज्रासन, दोनों फीट साथ में, शोल्डर रिलैक्स, बैक सीधा, ब्रीद हियर। ओके, यहां फाइनल पोस्चर हम करेंगे शशांक आसन ब्रीदिंग। इसके लिए आपका राइट हैंड को लेफ्ट हैंड से पकड़ लेंगे पीछे, एंड हल्का सा हाथ ऊपर, शोल्डर एकदम रिलैक्स। यहाँ इनहेल करते हुए लेंथन आउट योर स्पाइन, हल्का सा चिन अप, एक्सहेल करते हुए यू गो कोलैप्स, कोलैप्स योर एल्बो, शोल्डर्स एंड योर नेक। अगेन इनहेल, कम अप, एक्सहेल। Once you go down, collapse your elbow, shoulders, neck. यहाँ थोड़ी देर breathe करेंगे। Again, inhale, exhale. Inhale. Okay. ये शशांक आसन breathing. Another excellent practice है, because हमारे solar plexus में 72,000 नाड़ी का मिलन होता है। So by doing this practice, we are cleansing all the vital energy channels in our body. So उसको महसूस करते हुए और एक बार दो तीन बार करेंगे, inhale, back सीधा, chest out, shoulder relax, exhale. Once you go down, collapse, cool down, breathe. Again, inhale. Relax. Okay, ये शशांक आसन ब्रीदिंग भी आप जितना आपसे आपको अच्छा लग रहा है, you can always do as per your capacity. Now, इसके बाद थोड़ी देर हम शिथिल दंडासन में रिलैक्स करेंगे, जहां आपको नेक रखना है, साइड या पीछे या आगे, जो भी आपको कंफर्टेबल है वहां रिलैक्स करेंगे। अगर चाहिए तो थोड़ी देर शवासन में भी आप रिलैक्स कर सकते हैं। सो मेजर बेनिफिट ऑफ ऑल दिस योगिक पोस्चर्स are not only to strengthen your muscular structure, but also all the energy channels in your body will get nicely cleansed. With this cleansed body and your energy channel, now it is the turn to do pranayama practices. देखिए, अगर आपका muscular structure strong नहीं है, आप अच्छा पोजिशन में नहीं बैठ पा रहे हो, योर पोजिशन इज हियर एंड यू आर ट्राइंग टू डू, कुछ भी नहीं होने वाला, बिकॉज देयर इज नो स्पेस फॉर योर लंग्स टू एक्सपैंड। सो फर्स्ट यू नीड टू इंक्रीज द थोरैसिक वॉल्यूम, क्लेंस ऑल द नाडीज इन योर सिस्टम बाय डूइंग ऑल द योगा प्रैक्टिसेस। Of course, all the yogic postures are very excellent practice to enhance your
muscular strength. Okay, but today keeping this concentrating more on our respiratory function, I have designed this practices. So standing में हमने किया पांच practices. एक तो ताड़ासन, अर्धकटी चक्रासन, wall push and two types of wall pushes, and then we did utkutasan and then ardha chakrasan. Abhi sitting mein humne char practices kiye. One, dandasan and naukasan, oblique crunches, aur uske baad humne bhujangasan kiye. Bhujangasan mein relax hone ke baad humne शशांकासन ब्रीदिंग किए. नाउ आफ्टर शशांकासन ब्रीदिंग थोड़ा रिलैक्स होने के बाद, नाउ आवर बॉडी इज परफेक्टली रेडी टू डू प्राणायाम ब्रीदिंग प्रैक्टिसेस. ओके, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल प्रैक्टिस एंड अ वेरी वेरी सिंपल प्रैक्टिस इज योगिक ब्रीदिंग. योगिक ब्रीदिंग में क्या है, वी आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन दिस three-dimensional expansion of our lung volume. So, yahan kya hota hai? So, we are keeping preferably chin mudra or sitting in any comfortable position. Agar aapko aisa baithne ko achha nahi lag raha hai, aap extra mat aapka hip ke niche rakhe ya takiya rakhe aap baith sakte hain ya chair ke upar baith sakte hain, but preferably on the floor. Okay, see, yeah, there is equal spread of weight throughout your lower body. Haath ye nahi rakhna hai, ye relax rakhna hai. Shoulders ekdam, visualize your shoulder moving away from your ears. Your abdomen totally relaxing. Take your time to relax and establish a good posture. योगिक ब्रीदिंग प्रैक्टिस के लिए हम वन इनहेलेशन में पहला एब्डोमेन को डाउन एंड आउट पुश करेंगे, थोरैसिक को एकदम हल्क ओपन करेंगे, एज इफ योर रिब केज इज ओपनिंग टू द फ्रंट साइड एंड बैक, एंड आपका कैविकुलर जो है ऊपर की तरफ एक्सपैंडिंग. सो वन गुड इनहेलेशन, बल्ज योर स्टमक आउट. Open out your thoracic, lengthen out your clavicular. Don't hunch your shoulders, let it totally relax. With exhalation, relax your clavicular, your chest, and totally pull your abdomen in and relax. Thodi der yogic breathing karenge. Slow, deep inhalations, slow and longer exhalations. Literally, you're pushing visibly your stomach out, opening your chest and lengthening your clavicular upwards. Exhaling, again feel that again three-dimensional change in your lung happening. By doing yogic breathing, you're enhancing that oxygen inhalation capacity of your lungs. Once you have a good amount of oxygen in your body, of course, all the organs in your body, they get good oxygen to repair and rejuvenate themselves. So it's important you breathe right. And yogic breathing is one of this beautiful technique. Okay? So this yogic breathing, again, you fix your time, you fix your capacity and listen to your body and do the practice. After yogic breathing, we'll be doing Bhastrika Kriya. Bhastrika Kriya is an excellent practice again to expel all the waste out of your system. If you have any strain in your neck and shoulders, you can do the same practice keeping your hands down like this. Exhalation, or else we are inhaling up, exhaling down. So it goes like this. And relax. Relax and observe. One more round. Inhale. Exhale and relax. Observe. Immediately you'll feel that sense of freshness when you're doing this Bhastrika practices. Here, your inhalation is active and exhalation is forceful. Both the inhale, exhale at the same speed. Okay? Again, ye Bhastrika practice, aapke hisab se, how many round repetitions you want you can do and how many rounds you want you can do. And then take a break. Main thing is, jaise hum khana khane ke baad, we try to enjoy the taste of it. Then we enjoy the food more. We enjoy the smell and the taste of it. Like that only, after doing every practice, you try and feel. Feel whatever sensation happening in your whole system. And try to enjoy that sensation. Iske baad hum karenge Kapalbhati Kriya. Kapalbhati is the most effective practice to expel that waste out of your system. See, when we are breathing naturally, it is always apna inhalation jo hai, wo active rehta hai. Aur exhalation apne aap ho jata hai. It's a passive exhalation when we are doing natural breathing. But in Kapalbhati, we reverse the cycle. Here, we are exhaling actively and inhaling passively. So by involving your intelligence in exhalation, automatically jo bhi aapka oxidation hai, aapka carbon dioxide, everything is thrown out of your system. So that is why, of course, there is, again, as I said, whenever you're doing any yogic practice, it always has a physical benefit, therapeutic benefit, and the spiritual benefit. I'm not going too much into the spiritual benefit of it. We are sticking to the physical benefit of it. Especially today, we are concentrating more on our waste expulsion. Okay. So, in this Kapalbhati, your exhalation is active. And people with any abdominal operation, hernia, or ladies in their menstrual cycle, they won't be able to do this practice. Others, it's quite safe. Here also, make sure there is no strain in your back when you are doing this practice. If you're getting a strain in your back, then something wrong you are doing. You have to get it corrected. So otherwise, it's a simple practice. As we inhale, how my abdomen goes down and out. Same way, here, actively we are exhaling abdomen in and up. Try and feel that sensation in and up, in and up. So it goes like this. Take a good deep inhalation. Relax, observe. As I said, our oblique and core muscles are the one which facilitate the, especially the exhalation. So in this, automatically, all these muscles are getting engaged to expel that extra
waste out of your system. So feel that sensation as if you are throwing all that waste out of your system, all the impurities coming out of your system. With this sensation, with this feeling, with this bhavana, we'll do one more practice. Take a nice deep inhalation. Observe. Again, try and be with your body, be with your sensation. This Kapalbhati also, aapke hisab se. If you are able to exhale continuously for a longer period, you go ahead and do it. And you take a break and again repeat the next round. You have to always listen to your body and do the practice accordingly. Just always keep listening. If there is something wrong, your body will definitely let you know. So any yogic practices or any pranayama you are doing, there should not be any discomfort. Of course, there will be stretch and strain, but it should not be uncomfortable. So it has to be ekdam relaxed and enhanced practice. You have to keep that in mind and listen to your body and do the practices as per your capacity. And one last pranayama technique is Anulom Vilom. It's a quite famous pranayama wherein we are inhaling, exhaling, inhaling, exhaling. Okay? So, but today we'll be doing with little extra variation because we are trying to enhance that lung capacity. We'll do this practice with Antaranga Kumbhaka, holding the breath internally. So always jabhi bhi aap anulom vilom shuru karte hai, aapka chandra nadi se, left nadi se hi aapko begin karna rehta hai. Okay? So aap nashika mudra karenge. Agar ye mudra nahi samajh mein aa raha hai, you can always just do this, but preferably nashika mudra. ये तम को राइट नॉस्ट्रल से बंद करेंगे, नॉस्ट्रल को बंद करेंगे. इनहेल लेफ्ट, होल्ड द ब्रेथ, 4, 3, 2, 1. एक्सहेल थ्रू योर राइट. इनहेल राइट, होल्ड, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale through your left. ये जो inhalation, retention, exhalation, इसका आपने समझो अभी आप 4 count inhale किया, 1, 2, 3, 4. Try to retain the breath at least 4 counts or 8 counts. And try to exhale 8 counts. Again, inhale 4 counts. Hold 4 or 8 counts, exhale 8 counts. So it is 1:2, 2:2 breathing. Jitna aap inhale karte hai, usse double hold karne ka koshish karenge, uska double exhale karne ka koshish karenge. Fir se inhale karenge, 4 counts, hold 8 count, exhale 8 counts. Okay, so once we will do this practice, make sure your spine is straight, shoulder is relaxed. First full exhalation karenge, rate check. Inhale, pura through your left nostril. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold the breath for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale through your right. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale right. 4, 3, 2, 1. Close. Hold that breath. for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale, left nostril. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. नाड़ी शोधन विद अंतरंग कुंभकम, आपके हिसाब से, आपके टाइम के हिसाब से, आपका बॉडी के हिसाब से आप प्रैक्टिस करेंगे। अगर आप चाहिए तो 1:4:2 ब्रीदिंग भी कर सकते हैं। अगर आप चाहिए तो 16 काउंट अंदर होल्ड करके 8 काउंट एक्सहेल कर सकते हैं। So you see your capacity and do the practice. So to sum up this whole sequence, we did few practices standing, few practices on the mat, few practice on the prone position, and then we did this 4 breathing practices to enhance the capacity of our lungs. Breath is so important in yoga. It is said it is the only thread which connects your physical body and your mind. Ye aap bhi khud se kabhi try kijiye. Whenever you are angry or your heightened state of emotion when you have, automatically your breathing speed will be very high. So you take few minutes to just sit down and breathe for few seconds. Automatically aapka mind become calm. Okay, so this is a beautiful thread which connects our physical body and our mind, and it's a beautiful thread which connects this Atma to Paramatma, that total cosmic energy. Thank you.